After Marinduque Representative Lord Allan Velasco was named PDP-Laban's candidate for speakership, Velasco's main contender for the post, later Representative-elect Martin Romualdez says the race is still on. Royce Snagit with the report.
Later Representative-elect Martin Romualdez remains unfazed even after the ruling party PDP-Laban officially endorsed Marinduque Representative Lord Allan Velasco for House Speakership. In fact, just a few hours after the announcement on Wednesday, Romualdez met with some 40 lawmakers from various political parties and blocs. The congressman-elect, though, refused to call it a show of force.
This is a gathering of congressmen and congresswomen of like minds that want to work together hand in hand with the 18th Congress.
Some of the lawmakers present in the caucus were known allies of House Speaker Gloria Arroyo, just like Anak Kalusugan Representative-elect Mike Defensor, who is supporting Romualdez's speakership bid. Surprisingly, PDP-Laban member and Albay Congressman Joey Salceda, though, is questioning the decision of his party to endorse Velasco without consulting all members.
Kasi kung bibilangin namin yung nag-commit din kay Martin, 40, so it cannot be overwritten by some pronouncement from our, well, because there was no consultations. It's the president's choice to make, not for Manny Pacquiao.
The party-list coalition, on the other hand, which planned a block voting for House Speakership, is now divided on who they'll support as outgoing Speaker Gloria Arroyo's successor. Defensor said many party-list congressmen are disappointed with party-list coalition president and Juan Pacman representative Mikey Romero for signing the manifesto of support for Velasco without seeking their approval.
We never had a decision, we never had an agreement, at hindi namin sinusuportahan yung desisyon doon sa manifesto.
But during the coalition's emergency meeting last night, Romero explained to the group that he only signed the manifesto to avoid the proposed term sharing at the lower house.
To get the sense of other 30 members who are not present today. But we fully support the explanation of Mikey, which is to thwart the impending term sharing. Pero yung decision ho talaga sa July 2 pa.
Coalition member and Acobico representative Alfredo Garbin says their group fully understands Romero's decision. The group is set to meet again on July 2 to decide on who they will officially bet on in the speakership race. Over at the palace, though, the chief executive insists that he will not meddle in the leadership affairs in Congress. But he did say that he will announce his favored candidate on Friday. In a statement, the palace said Duterte is leaving the choice for the next speaker to lawmakers in the lower house. Before this, Duterte asked Speaker Arroyo to take her pick, but she refused. Arroyo, Salceda, and Defensor are former members of the Lakas CMD party, which is headed by Romualdez. Romualdez is said to have been instrumental in the election of Arroyo as speaker, replacing Pantaleon Alvarez in the infamous house coup in last year's SONA. Romualdez says that while there's weight on the endorsement of the president and the speaker, he believes that his colleagues will still vote for the most qualified candidate.
We are confident that we are a strong contender and that we will not stop working, and even beyond July 22.
For News 5, Royce Snagit, We Are One News.